Dovey is my little wife. Or small person.
She says not to try to be funny. By the time you were born, we've been married 7 years, and so we had lived without a baby for such a long time. It was hard to imagine what it was going to be like to have a child.
This program is called Scenes from the Life of Lola.
Lola. Good morning, Lola. Good morning, Lola.
Initially, we were thinking, oh, Lulu. We loved, you know, Lulu Lorber. We really wanted alliteration. We thought that sounded so good. And maybe it was the painkillers that I was on, or, you know, just, you know, the post-birth. But I thought that was a great idea. And Richard sort of looked at me and he said, you know, if we name her Lulu, she's gonna grow up and be a stripper. And I thought, you know, you're right. And maybe we don't want to force that upon her. Maybe we don't want her to only have one career option. So there also was already a Lulu in our family. Richard had a giant stuffed polar bear that he slept with in college because no one else would sleep with him then. And, you know, we didn't really want to have two Lulus in our family. So we were thinking, okay, we can't name her Lulu. How about Molly? That's a little more basic, a little more, you know, conservative. But we didn't really want basic and conservative. We didn't want her to grow up and be a lawyer like myself. We didn't want her to, you know, be a businesswoman like Richard. My grandmother, Lola's great-great-grandmother, was named Dovey. And my mother was named Bess, and she named me Dovey, Dovey Chandler Wingard. And I named my daughter Dovey Frances Wingard. And so when my Dovey, little Dovey, was pregnant, I was hoping that she would give the name Dovey, but she decided on Lola, which is just darling, but a little bit disturbing to me because I was worried that she was gonna name her or give her the nickname of Lolita, which was a pornographic film in my day and still is very controversial, but I just told her, you know, you can name her Lola, but if you call her Lolita, I'm not going to like that. I do not care for that name one bit. And I told her, I don't think she should read that book or see that movie. That would just be terrible. So we thought about it some more and we came across the name Lola. We didn't hear any of the songs, any of the plays, any of the books, any of the movies, any of the anything. We just thought, you know, Lola Lorber. That sounds nice. That sounds like the name of our daughter. And with Lola, you know, it's a little bit sexual. She could very well become a stripper if she wants.
Her name was Lola. She was a show.